When automakers put out a concept car, it's like the ultimate tease, because by the time the vehicle makes it to production, it of course looks nothing like the concept. Which is why when Lexus revealed the production version of the LC 500 coupe and this, the convertible counterpart, everyone was really excited, because here was a concept car you could actually buy and drive. We're going to take a look at the LC 500 convertible today. Speaking of concept making its way to production, look at this grille. It is Lexus's spindle grille, but it has no more dramatic an application than on the LC 500. I think it looks fantastic with the chrome accents. Looks so cool. We've got these triple beam LED projector headlights with daytime running lights that are in this spear shape. Super cool. Turn signals down there. Moving to the side, we see the set of optional 21-inch forged alloy wheels, also look great with the black painted accents on the inside. The profile is sweeping and elegant and so beautiful with an upturned portion here that connects very nicely with the folding fabric roof when that is up. At the back, the deck lid is so long and graceful. And here at the tail, we have these LED tail lights with this really cool 3D effect, like looking into the beam. And down low, we have this blacked out diffuser with these chrome finishers. It looks like it's split dual exhaust ports, but it's actually just two outlines with four pipes. From nose to tail, I think the LC 500 convertible is just gorgeous, especially in this eye-catching infrared paint. Under the hood of the LC 500, you get a 5.0-liter naturally aspirated V8 that makes 471 horsepower and 398 pound-feet of torque, connected to a 10-speed automatic gearbox, sending power to just the rear wheels. This vehicle gets to 60 in 4.6 seconds, onto a top speed of 168 miles per hour. The fuel economy is only going to be 18 combined from 15 city and 25 highway, but if you want better fuel economy, they do offer a hybrid version. Inside the LC 500 is just an exquisitely beautiful cabin. This one has the optional touring package, so you get these semi-aniline leather seats. They're heated and ventilated. You also get a 13-speaker Mark Levinson sound system. We also have an optional head-up display in this vehicle. Standard is going to be a 10.3-inch infotainment. It is not a touchscreen. You have this trackpad down here that's pretty responsive, and it's got nice physical controls for things like volume and seek, but I still think I'd prefer something like a rotary dial with hotkeys and zones like you might find from BMW's iDrive system. Not bad. Could be improved. You also have physical controls for your climate. That is also nice, not having to hunt around in the menus to adjust the temperature. There's a digital TFT display in front of the driver as well that can move left to right depending on your settings. It's just a really cool effect. And these antennas coming out of the gauge cluster housing look kind of wild. Your drive modes are on the right-hand side, on the left is your traction control system. This steering wheel is wrapped in leather and heated, feels perfect in the hands with these paddle shifters, nice aluminum ones on the back of the steering wheel. I'm just overwhelmed with this cabin. It's so luxurious, so comfortable, beautiful to look at in this toasted caramel leather color. I just don't know if anyone's gonna be able to fit in those back seats with the seat in my drive position at 6 feet tall. But wait, how do you put up the soft top? I don't see any controls for it here. Well, if you know, you know. Oh boy, behind the wheel of the LC 500 convertible, comfort, the essence of comfort, is just so saturated in this driving experience. The seating position is perfect. The seat hugs you so nicely in place. The ride quality is excellent. And with the windows up and this wind baffle back here, the wind noise never gets too bad. And with the top up, it's honestly almost as quiet as the coupe. I could not believe it. It's amazing. And even in comfort drive mode, you can just hear the burble of that V8 in the background. It is so, so nice. But in comfort drive mode, all the other performance elements are sort of subdued. You always have that soundtrack, but the throttle tip-in is very light. The brake pedal is smooth. The steering inputs are not too sharp and overexcited. This is just a really great cruiser convertible. The transmission adds to that experience as well, because it's a 10-speed. It sounds like a lot of gears that you have to go through, but it works through them completely imperceptibly. You have no idea that you're changing gear. And I can't believe how good this turning radius is for such a long vehicle. It's so tidy. My goodness. And then the moment the opportunity presents itself for you to have a bit more fun behind the wheel, you can just crank the right antenna up to Sport, or maybe even Sport Plus. Put your foot down. Oh, and just appreciate that gorgeous V8 noise. The brakes are nice and sharp. The steering is much more immediate with more weight to the wheel. If you want to do your own shifting, you just pull on a paddle. Ooh, and that snap of noise. Oh, and it gets so much better in the upper part of the rev range. here getting towards the red line of 7,000 RPM. Listen to that. And the snap of the upshift. Oh, I don't think there are many engines that sound better in production today than this. Cannot get enough of that. Now, especially in these tight corners, you never really quite forget the fact that this vehicle weighs as much as it does. It changes direction admirably for that weight, but you can always kind of still feel it. You just forget about that though, with that soundtrack. Oh, so good. But the Lexus LC 500 convertible does not exist in a silo, so we gotta talk about competition. The starting price for this vehicle is $102,000. As tested, we're looking at $113,000. Stack that up against the Porsche 911 Carrera Cabriolet, just the base model convertible. That one starts at $113,000. It makes a lot less power, 379 horsepower, but it's quicker to 60, 4.2 seconds. Then we have the Jaguar F-Type R convertible. That one starts at 106,000, so still a little more than this. Makes a lot more power though at 575 horsepower. 0 to 60 is quite a bit quicker at 3.5 seconds. Then we have the newly reborn kid on the block, causing a lot of waves with that starting price, the Chevy Corvette convertible. $68,000 to start, undercutting the competition by quite a large margin, while still making 495 horsepower and having the quickest acceleration of the bunch, 2.9 seconds. Which should you choose? Well, I think if it comes down to looks alone, I think this Lexus LC 500 convertible is just the most striking vehicle of the bunch, and arguably the most comfortable, the most luxurious, the quietest, with an incredible soundtrack. But that 21 Chevy Corvette convertible is quite the bargain. The performance is insane. The upgrades that you can add to the interior to make it more luxurious are very, very nice. That's this vehicle's toughest competition, and I think if you have under $100,000 to spend, go for that convertible. If you have more to spend and you really appreciate the looks of this car, go for it, because you will not be disappointed. I hope you guys enjoyed this review, and if you want to learn more about any of the vehicles I mentioned, click the link in the description below or go to automakers.com. Until next time, oh, that V8.